Although they may not be immediately apparent, the consequences of the uncountability of languages are rather profound. We'll let sigma be the set of ASCII characters. These are all the ones you would need to write a computer program. And observe that the set of strings that represent valid Python programs is a subset of sigma star. Each program is a finite string, after all. And note here that I chose Python arbitrarily. You could choose any language or set of languages if you liked. Well, since this set is a subset of the countable set sigma star, we have that it is countable. Thus, there are a countable number of Python programs. On the other hand, consider this fact. For any language L, we can define f sub L to be the function that is 1 if x is in L and 0 otherwise. All such functions are distinct, so the set of these functions must be uncountable. Or in other words, the set of functions from sigma star to 0, 1 is uncountable. Here is the profound point. Since the set of valid Python programs is countable, but the set of functions is not, it follows that there must be some functions that we just can't write computer programs for. In fact, there are uncountably many of them. So, going back to our picture of the high school classroom, we can see that the teacher, perhaps without realizing it, was talking about something much more general than what the student ended up thinking. There are only countably many computer programs that can follow a finite number of steps, as the student was thinking, but there are uncountably many functions that fit the teacher's definition.